I live in Montreal, originally from Israel. Came a long way. And I'm at the Andes Sprout Society for 2 weeks. I think this is just the middle point. Mm-hmm. 1 week has passed, and I'm doing a time-lapse of sprouts. So it's a time-lapse photography. The growth of the sprouts take about 10 days. I actually wrote a software to do the time-lapse so I can modify it myself, but since it's a process that takes about 2 weeks, so I was afraid that it might crash. So I'm using a commercial software in the house, and it works with a growth light, and I have two views. One of them is an aerial view and one of them is a frontal view of the same sprouts, so then I can compare the way that they look from above and from the side. I mean, I'm a video artist, so I work a lot with the time, as it's natural with any time-based media. And I did one project where I had a lot of short videos that each of them shows a process of growth and decay of movement. And I did do one time-lapse of a sprout in this video, and that just drew me to try to make more and more videos of different sprouts and try to see the patterns of growth that they hold within. And my plan is to capture like 10 sprouts growing and then have a wall when they like grow up and down. But I think it will have to take a lot of time because it takes a lot of patience to document them, because things happen in midway and sometimes they don't really make their way fully sprouting. So this is one part of the experiment. Okay, I found out about it because my professor posted it on the mailing list of the research lab that I'm part of in Concordia in Montreal. I'm not sure how he got hold of it, but the minute that I saw it, it just seemed like an amazing way to have a retreat from the city life and concentrate on work. So it sounded kind of magical, and I sent an application and got accepted, and I'm very happy to be here.
And what's the cabin like?
The quarters. It's housed in the middle of a big field with beautiful sunsets. The cabin is very simple but very zen-like, with a wood interior and beautiful windows overlooking the view of the city of Stamford. I haven't had any electricity until now, but I think today I'll have the solar panels hooked up because I'm the first artist of the season, so it wasn't set up. But it's nice to be with candlelights, and but it's very peaceful, and it's a great retreat to just concentrate on work.